students, in previous class I said fifth lesson coordination, in that structure of nerve cell completed, and also I explained synapse. Once again I repeat the parts of nerve cell. Nerve cell is the structural and functional unit of nervous system. Nerve cell consists of majorly three parts: axon, cyton, dendrites. When neurons are united together to form synapse, synapse is a functional region of contact between two neurons where information is passed from one neuron to another neuron. Now I will explain about two types of nerves in human body. Before that, a scientist called Galen, Galen is a Greek physiologist. What is meant by physiologist? The person who study about the functioning of internal organs like brain, kidney, heart, etc. So that study is called physiology. That person is called physiologist. Physiologist means the person who study about functioning of internal organs. Galen is a Greek physiologist. One of his patient, one of his patient which fell down from chariot, and he got a blow near neck region, and he lose the sensation, but he is showing muscular movements. One of his patient which fell down from chariot, he get a blow near neck region, he lose the sense, but he is showing muscular activities, muscular muscle movement. Based on this, Galen concluded that two types of nerves present in human body, that is called sensory nerve. One is sensory nerve and second one is motor nerve. There are two types of nerves in human body. One is sensory nerve, another one is motor nerve. Sensory nerve also called as efferent nerve, and motor nerve also known as efferent nerve. Efferent nerve and efferent nerve. What is the use of sensory nerves? Sensory nerves carry messages from sense organs to brain or spinal cord. Here, efferent nerves, also known as motor nerves, carry messages from brain or spinal cord to sense organs. Do you know sensory nerves also called as incoming nerves? Motor nerves also called as outgoing nerves. So these are the three differences between sensory nerves and motor nerves. So outgoing nerves. Again I repeat, sensory nerves and motor nerves. There are two types of nerves in human body, that is called sensory nerves and motor nerves. Sensory nerves also called as efferent nerves, and motor nerves also called as efferent nerves. Sensory nerves carry messages from sense organs like eye, ear, nose, skin, tongue to brain or spinal cord. Motor nerves carry messages from brain or spinal cord to sense organs like eye, ear, nose, skin, tongue. They are also known as incoming nerves. They are also known as outgoing nerves. They are helpful to detect the sense of object. Motor nerve helpful for movement. Motor nerve helpful for movement. These are the differences between sensory nerves and motor nerves. Here I drew some two diagrams. One is sensory nerve and second one is motor nerve. Majorly two types of nerves. One is sensory nerve and second one is motor nerve. Sensory nerve carry messages from sense organs to brain or spinal cord. Motor nerve carry messages from brain or spinal cord to sense organs. So this is sensory nerve and motor nerve. Sometimes they'll ask like this. They only will give diagram to you in the exam point of view, and they'll ask what type of nerve is. This is sensory nerve and this is motor nerve. If you look through this pathway, we can find out associate nerves also. Already I explained two types of nerves now, that is sensory nerves and motor nerves. Sensory nerves also called as efferent nerves, motor nerves also called as efferent nerves. Here this sensory nerve are also called as efferent nerve, carry messages from sense organs to brain or spinal cord. Here motor nerve also called as efferent nerves, which carry messages from brain or spinal cord to muscles or organs or sense organs. So if you look in this flow chart, we can find out another nerve that is known as associate nerve, which can sometimes this can act as sensory nerves, means which carry messages from muscles organs to spinal cord. Sometimes this also acts as motor nerves, means that carry messages from brain or spinal cord to muscles or organs. So these are known as associate nerves. Associate nerves means associate nerves also known as mixed nerves, means they can act as both sensory nerves and motor nerves, means sometimes they carry messages from sense organs to brain or spinal cord, sometimes they carry messages from brain or spinal cord to sense organs. So this type of nerves are known as associate nerves, which means associate nerves means the nerves which can act as both sensory and motor nerves. They are also known as mixed nerves. Sometimes they will ask like this. They give flow chart with empty boxes and they will ask, fill the flow chart. Okay, you have to learn here sensory organs, efferent nerves carry messages from sensory organs to brain or spinal cord. Brain or spinal cord releases responses. These responses carried by efferent nerves to the muscles or spinal cord. Muscles and spinal cord shows appropriate action. If you observe in this flow chart, we can find out another special nerve that is called associate nerves. Associate nerves sometimes acts as sensory nerves and sometimes acts as motor nerves. This is about nervous pathway. See, here we learnt about two types of nerves according to Galen, a Greek physiologist. One of his patients which fell down from chariot and he get a blow near neck region. That person lose sense but he is showing movement. According to Galen, two types of nerves in human body, that is sensory nerves and motor nerve. This is the sensory nerve which carry messages from sense organ to brain or spinal cord, and this is the motor nerve which carry messages from brain or spinal cord to sense organs. So this is about nervous pathway. Now I will explain about central nervous system. Already in previous class I explained about nervous system. Nervous system and endocrine system will bring coordination in human body. Now we are in nervous system. Afterwards I will explain about our endocrine system. If you will observe in nervous system, we can find out three divisions, that is central nervous system, second one is peripheral nervous system, and third one is autonomous nervous system. There are three divisions in nervous system. One is central nervous system, second one is peripheral nervous system, third one is autonomous nervous system. In central nervous system, we can find out majorly two parts, that is brain and spinal cord. Brain and spinal cord under comes to central nervous system. Now we are in central nervous system. In that, I will explain about brain. Do you know, brain is the most important complicated organ in animal kingdom. We can do anything with the help of brain. Without brain, we can't do anything. Now, I will explain about location where brain will be present. Brain present in a bony case called cranium. Brain present in a bony case called cranium, which is made up of skull bones. Brain, cranium is made up of skull bones. In Telugu, it is called kapalam. And if you lecture in brain, we can find out three membranes. These membranes are also known as meninges. What are the three membranes which surround the brain? Already I explained in previous classes. There are two double-layered membrane in lungs, that is called pleura, and double-layered membrane in heart is called pericardium. Now, three membrane which surrounds the brain known as meninges, that is outer, middle, inner membranes. Outer membrane is known as dura mater. Middle membrane also known as arachnoid membrane. Inner membrane is called pia mater. There are three membranes which surround the brain. One is outer membrane, middle membrane, inner membrane. Outer membrane known as dura mater, middle membrane also known as arachnoid membrane, inner membrane known as pia mater. These three membranes filled with fluid known as cerebrospinal fluid, simply called as CSF, cerebrospinal fluid, a fluid which moves around the three membranes, outer membrane dura mater, middle membrane arachnoid membrane, inner membrane pia mater. This fluid is known as cerebrospinal fluid. Do you know, children? One is cranium, second one is cerebrospinal fluid. Cranium and cerebrospinal fluid will give protection to the brain from shocks and injuries. These two structures, one is cranium and second one is cerebrospinal fluid, these two will give protection to the brain from shocks and blows. And now I will explain about color of brain. What is the color of brain? Outer layer, outer part of brain will be gray in color and the inner part of brain will be white in color. The outer part of brain is gray in color, the inner part of brain is white in color. Why outer part of brain will be gray in color means, due to the presence of cell bodies of neurons. Already I explained in the previous class. Cytoplasm also called as cell body. So, due to the presence of cell bodies of neurons, the outer part of brain will be gray in color. And inner part of brain will be white in color due to the presence of myelinated axons. If you will observe in nerve cell, we can find out axon, a nerve fiber, long fiber, which surrounded by a sheet known as myelin sheet. Due to the presence of myelinated axon, the inner part of brain will be white in color. If you will observe, the outer part of brain will be gray in color. No, this is known as cerebral cortex. Cerebral cortex. So, this is about color. The outer part of brain will be gray color due to the presence of cell bodies of neurons. The inner part of brain will be white in color due to the presence of myelinated axon. The outer part of brain gray in color, that is called as cerebral cortex. That is known as cerebral cortex. Now, I will explain about parts of brain. What are the three major parts of brain? One is forebrain, also called as cerebrum, and second part of brain is midbrain, and third part of brain is hindbrain. If you will observe in brain, we can find out three major parts. Already I explained three membranes which surround the brain: outer membrane, middle membrane, inner membrane. Outer membrane is called dura mater, middle membrane is called arachnoid membrane, inner membrane is called pyameter. These three membranes filled with the fluid called cerebrospinal fluid. These are the three parts. These are the membranes, simply called as meninges, and these three are the parts: forebrain, midbrain, hindbrain. Forebrain also called as cerebrum. Now I will explain about cerebrum. Do you know? Cerebrum is the largest part in human brain. Cerebrum, also called as forebrain. This is the largest part of human brain. This is the largest part in a human brain. This cerebrum helpful for thinking, memory, reasoning, etc. So this is about cerebrum. Cerebrum is the largest part. Most body functions will be controlled by a part known as cerebrum, simply called as forebrain. Forebrain also called as cerebrum, which controls all body activities. In the next class, I will draw the diagram of human brain and I will explain about the functions of human brain. Thank you.